solve your quiz, right? Do you want that I solve it or not?
Yes.
No?
No.
Yes, solve.
Okay. First question is find the spore reaction for the given frame, right? Now in this frame, there is one load which is inclined at some angle, right?
Yes.
Okay, and there is one load which is from the
wind load.
It's like a wind load. And this question, it is copied from your book as it is. Okay? I did not make any change. Okay? Exactly copied, okay? So it means don't think that if you have the solution with you, you can copy it, right? But I am telling you that if you were and you if you open your book, you can find this type of question. And this is exactly copied, okay? So over here, this is fixed board. We need to assume A is fixed, B is pin, and C is roller. And see, we need to assume a roller spore, okay? Now, for this pose, you can convert it into two components, right? The only thing over here is, what you have to do, you need to divide it into two parts, okay? So one will be this top part, another is this lower part. And it is given, what is spore over here, it is?
Hinge, internal hinge.
It is pin spore, right?
Yes.
So you need to assume A fix, B pin, C roller, okay? So now, separate it into two parts. So here, this is roller, this is pin. Now over here, this is fixed, okay? For time being, forget about this one. Now this force has two components. One will be this one, other is this one.
Yes.
One is this one, other is
horizontal,
is it?
Yes.
Okay, now from this component, you will get two reactions, this one and this one, okay? Then from this one, you will get reaction over here, is it?
Yes.
Now this reaction, basically this one, it will be applied over here in this direction, opposite, right? So this direction is applied over here.
Opposite.
In opposite, okay?
Yes.
Right? And then, so you can solve this part, is it?
Yes.
Then when these two are known, right? This UDL is known, you can find this reaction and this one. This was the question.
Doctor, okay. Can I find it without separation?
Without separation, not possible.
Because if I take the y-axis, it will be symmetry. So A and C.
So you are going to take movement over here, zero?
No.
Now if you don't take movement over here, zero, then it will be difficult. Because you have 3 plus 1, 4 on.
Yeah, but I will find it by symmetry, A and C.
Symmetry? No, it's not symmetric. It's not symmetric. Okay, so this is the ideal solution, right? I will check whatever you have done. Then the next problem, right? It is what is an ILD?
Find the internal
cross. What is an
ILD?
The variation of.
ILD is influence line diagram. Mm-hmm. It shows the variation of one function at one point when the load is moving along the length of it. Okay. Okay. Then question number two, right? Then three is draw shear force bending moment diagram. I think this is easy, right?
Yes.
For this. So we have two movements, one over here, other over here. All these lengths are 2, 2, and 2, right? This movement is same, right? It is 20 and 20, right? What was the reaction?
Zero,
right? So you can see, it's easy. So on this beam, clockwise, counterclockwise movement are equal, no load, right? So this will give you directly an idea that the reaction will be zero, no reaction. When there is no reaction, no load, shear force is zero everywhere, right?
Yes.
Only there will be pure bending moment in this part. So over here there will be, and this part is hogging, right? And it is negative moment.
It's
wrong. Okay? So it's not sagging, it is hogging, okay? So it is negative part. Okay, then, for question number four, right? So you need to complete the given figure only, right? So nothing else. So it is. So over here, there is a UDL, and it is wind load, right? Here it is fixed, right? Then this is 3 meter, and this one is 4 meter, and this is 12 kilonewton per meter, right? Now it is asked to complete this diagram, okay? So only asked to complete this diagram, right? Now, want to, right? About 6 hours from they ask me, what is port over here? My dear, it is free, right? So you can see it is free end, right? So this is fixed. If you consider fixed over here, there will be 6 unknown. How you can solve it? Okay, so it is free, right? Okay, then from this, there is any movement, I remove the movement, right? So mind it, before, now here there is no movement, right? But in the start, I also apply a movement over here and over here, right? But when I change it, I make it simple. Okay, just only one window. Okay, anyway, so this one is, this load is 36. What about vertical? It will be zero. This movement will be 36 into 1.5.
54.
So now you can see this is 36. This one is 54, right? So just what will be this one?
36
and 54. Same will be here. 36 and 54. This will be here, right? 36 and 54. Now you will reach up to the last member, right? So this is 36 and this one is 54. Now, when you will see the last member, right? So this one is 12 kilonewton per meter, and this is 3 meter. It is exactly in equilibrium. You can check, right?
Yes.
So this is 12 into 3, 36 in this direction, this 36 in this direction, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this one is, what is movement over here?
Zero.
From this one, it will be 54, and from this one, you can check, right? So the final movement will be zero. Clear? Okay, so only this answer was required. This was question number 4. For question number 5, now the statement of this question is complete the following to draw the shear force, axial force and bending moment, okay? Means I will use later this one to draw the shear force, right?
Yes.
Not, you don't need to draw it, okay? Okay, next question number 5, how we can find the absolute maximum bending moment for a simply supported beam when it is subjected to a set of moving load?
Find the resultant and it will be at equal distance.
So it's fine, it's ideal answer is that your absolute maximum bending moment will be under one of the point load such that the point load and the resultant, they are at equal distance from the center line.
Yes.
Okay. Then draw ILD for support reaction at point P, right? So for this beam, right? So this is point P. So you need to draw ILD for reaction. What will be that?
1.
So this will be 1, right? Then join it. So this is 6 and 2.
Yeah.
So this will be, I think, 1.33. Okay. Because the simple rule is, if you want to draw ILD for reaction at P, increase it by 1.
Okay. No need to write the numbers, right?
No, no. In this case, it is required, right? Because it is to draw the ILD. It is not, in the next question, it is given. Draw the qualitative ILD.
Qualitative, yes.
Okay. So in the next question, first last question is draw the qualitative ILD for bending movement at point C, right? So. And I think most of the students can solve this one. So at this point, you need to draw qualitative ILD. Just apply these two moments, draw this shape, right? So this shape will give you the
qualitative
ILD. So you can draw it again and you can say this is ILD for
bending
moment at point
C.
Okay. This is your quiz. Okay. So now let's start. Let's continue our discussion about our main topic. So you know your last quiz, it will be on the last working day, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Quiz 4, it is on the last working day, okay?
Yes.
Okay, so last time we were discussing about displacement and rotation by using virtual work method. Okay, so let's continue with the same discussion.
Displacement
and rotation. By using virtual work method. Anything which is not clear. By using virtual work method. The other name is unit load method. can find delta, and it is equal to 0 to n into m into capital M over E I into dx, right? Mind it is E I, it is not E A, okay? It is E I. And theta, it is equal to 0 to f, m theta into m over E I into dx. Last I will use this equation, first one to find the displacement. Today we are going to use this second one to find the rotation. Now I am going to solve a quick example to see you how, to show you how we can use this equation to find the rotation. Okay. In this example, you need to find the rotation at free end of the given beam. Statement is find rotation at free end by using virtual work method. Okay. So we have this simply cantilever beam, and it is subjected to a this is point A and this is point B. So at point B we need to find the rotation. Find the rotation at free end. What it means, if I draw as elastic curve, it will be like this, is it?
Yes,
so what I am going to do, I draw a tangent at its free end. So I need this angle theta, is it?
Yes.
So this is theta B, right? So I need this theta B. So to find theta B, suppose this, I can give you some, what do you need? Do I use numerical values for the length and load or some fixed values? Numerical or some arbitrary values? L and M?
Yes.
So this length is L and applied load is M?
Yes.
Because with,
yeah,
with constant values it's easy, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so let's write it. This one as
L.
Any value, right?
Yes.
And this one is any load W, right?
Yes.
Okay, so let's solve it. Now in the solution. So what do you need? You need theta, right? So therefore, we will have the equation 0 to L m theta into m over EI into
dx.
Okay, let's have the fixed value of EI. Okay? So EI is
constant.
And you know what is meaning of constant, right?
Yes.
Means along the length, it is not changing.
Same material.
So same material, same section all along the length of beam. Okay, now. For M, how to find for capital M, okay? So what I can do, I can cut a section because M is movement due to movement equation due to the applied loading, right? So here M will be, I can just cut a section over here and I can find MX over here. What will be this distance?
X.
This is X. X is changing in this direction. Okay. Therefore, from this one, what will be your M value? Is equal to, this is W, right? W into X into X over 2, is it correct?
Yes.
Okay, so this will be equal to N. It is minus, is it correct?
Yes.
Because load is acting downward.
Downward,
yes. So it is minus WX into X over 2. So it is minus WX square over
2.
So M is fine. Now what next? We need to find the small m, or M theta, right? Now for M theta,
in this moment,
what we can do, we can apply, this time we need to find rotation, right?
Yes.
Therefore we will apply a unit rotation, okay, unit movement, right, at point
B.
At that point where you need the rotation, right? Okay, so for that I am going to remove the applied load. Okay, so this length is how much? It is
L.
So this point is A, this point is
B.
At point B, I am applying a rotation. Okay. So this rotation is how much? This is movement is unit, right? 1.0. Okay.
Yes.
And again at the same distance, like in the previous one.
Cut the section.
So from here to here, this distance is X. I am going to find the M theta, right? So what will be m theta now? M theta, it is equal to what? What is movement over here?
Equal to the unit load.
Start from
unit load?
One.
Okay, so over here, if you see the movement,
minus
if there
one.
Is any force over here, no, right?
No.
Minus
so
one.
Therefore, you don't need to multiply with distance.
Yes.
Right? Only here is an external movement unit, right?
Yes.
Therefore, it is equal to 1. And it is positive 1 or negative 1?
Negative.
Negative, because it is acting downward. Or you can say it is creating hogging, right?
Hogging, yeah.
So it is equal to minus 1.0. So that's it. So this is equation for m theta. So now let's put these two values of m and capital M and small m over here. And let's integrate it. Therefore, from 1, okay? So this is our equation 1. That will be theta, it is equal to 0 to L small m, right? It is minus 1 into minus
x square over 2.
W x square over 2 over EI into dx. Okay. So, and this is theta b, right? So theta b, it will be equal to EI is constant, right?
Yes.
What about minus and minus, it will be
positive.
2 is constant, W is constant, is
yes.
it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so it will be equal to
W
W into 2 EI over 2 EI, is that correct?
Yes.
Yes.
Into 0 to L into X square into because X is the only thing which is changing along this equation, right?
Yes.
Okay. So this will be equal to W over 2 EI into X cube over D and it is from 0 to L. So it is equal to W over 2 EI into 1 over 3 into L cube minus 0 cube, is it?
Yes.
To put the limits, right? So it will be equal to WL cube over 6 EI, is it?
Yes.
WL cube over
6
EI.
Yes.
Easy, very easy, right? So just find two values of M, capital M and small m, and put it in the basic equation, right? Okay, so with this one, this problem is over, right? Now, let's start another one. Now, I am going to show you. Yes.
On the last member, when we the M small, we consider a unit load or a movement.
When we want to find displacement, then if you consider the unit load, and because this is for this small m, and it is delta is required, we will consider a unit load. But when rotation is required, we will apply the unit movement at that point, okay? And our answer is positive. What is meaning of positive?
Our assumption is
means this direction. Over here we are assuming that rotation is in this direction, right? This assumption is correct. It doesn't mean clockwise or counterclockwise over here, right? So we have whatever we have assumed, it is correct. Okay, so
Victor, if you want to find the rotation at point at the middle, for example,
okay.
So we have.
I am going to solve this problem.
Oh.
Okay. So now suppose we need some other case. May I use a simply supported beam now? So let's use a simply supported beam, right? An example of simply supported beam, and find the rotation at some point, okay? Find rotation and displacement at point B for given B, okay?
So,
yes.
Q minus this one, theta B.
Sorry?
Minus. Change this one. Theta B minus. What will
we
do? If
we
find theta B minus.
If you find minus, oh, okay, it means that whatever direction you are assuming over here, it is not correct, okay?
Okay,
so
change
and
this one?
No, do not need to change it. Your value is with you, right? And direction, you know, it is not in this direction, it is in the upward direction. Okay? If you want to try it, do not consider it downward, right? Consider it upward. Okay. So what will happen? So what you are assuming when you are applying upward direction, that this beam It will deform like this way, is it?
Exactly.
But actually it is not like this one. It is deforming like this one, is it?
Yes.
Okay, what will happen? If you consider upward, this will be positive, is it?
Yes.
So this positive is here, right? So it will be negative here, negative here, negative here, negative here. Okay? Because we make the wrong assumption over here, our answer will become negative. But it's okay, right? Now our final answer is, let's change the direction. Okay, now find rotation and displacement at point B for given beam, okay? So now we have a simply supported beam. Okay, and UDL. It is subjected to UDL. You can consider point load, no problem. Whatever you want. So over here, this is point A. This middle point is B. This is point C, right? And these lengths are, so let's use the length value, 3 meter and 3 meter, okay? And then, this UDL, it is, for example, 10 kilonewton per meter, okay? Here. Now, what I have to do, I need to find displacement at point B and rotation at point B. By the way, what will be rotation at point B?
Before or after?
Zero. Let's work for delta B first, okay? Then we will work for theta B, okay? For delta B, what we will do?
Okay.
So delta B, it is equal to from 0 to L into small m,
capital M,
capital M over
yeah.
EI into, later I will give you some value of EI as well, okay? Okay, M over EI into DS. How much time?
20 minutes.
So
20
more minutes.
Yes.
Okay, so delta B is from 0 to L, M over EI into DS, okay? So what will be value of small m, capital M?
Equation.
For capital M, what I can do?
Cut a section.
I can cut a section, right?
At point
so
B.
Over here, if you have this beam, right? So this is your
two
UDL,
points.
Right? So what will be this reaction
two
and
points.
This reaction?
After
can you tell me? These two reactions. So this total load is 10 into 6? 60. So half will be here, half will be here. It means this will be 30. And this one is
30.
Now if you start from this end, right? If you consider section over here, 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 everywhere, right? So the same equation is applicable, is it?
Yes.
So either you consider section here, everywhere you will have one load, one UDL. Is
yes.
it?
Yes.
But the problem is, at the same time, you need to see for small m, right? For small m. So now for small m, what will happen? What do you need? You need displacement at point B, right?
So
what you will do? You will remove this load and apply a unit load at point B,
yeah.
Is it? Okay, let's make that situation as well. So for this one, right? This is our beam, and here we are applying a unit load, right?
Yes.
What is this distance and this distance, it is 3 and 3 meters. These distances are 3 and 3, is it?
Yes.
Okay, now if you consider, what will be this reaction?
Half and half,
right?
Yes.
But you see, if you consider section over here, right, from this side, only one load, right?
Yes.
So it is okay. It is okay for all these cases. But when you move in this portion,
yeah.
What do you need? You need, your equation will be changed. It means, you will consider this one as separate segment, this one is as? So that's why over here, you will also have to consider two same segments, okay?
Yes.
Okay, so therefore, what we will do, we will make a point over here up to center, right?
Before and after.
Before and Okay, this is what do you mean by before and after? Okay. Okay, so over here we will consider one section over here and one section over here, right? So I can say this one is AB segment, this is the
C
segment, right? So over here I will have the equation, and let me say this distance is
x1.
Okay, x1. Yes. Mm. So what I will find over here, I will say it as capital M1, right?
Yes.
So when I will find for this segment, I will consider this distance as
x2.
And here I will find
M2. Let's return the C to.
No, no, it is from here, right?
What?
Sorry?
Not from support to.
Not necessarily, right? Either you consider it on the spot, you will get the same answer. There will be no difference. Okay? There will be no difference at all. Okay? So let me consider from here. This is x2, right?
Okay. Okay, but the reaction will not be considered. The third, if I consider from this.
It will be considered, right? No problem. Mm. Because this is a little bit difficult case. That's why I am considering it from here, right?
Mm.
Okay? Because for this segment, you already solved it, right?
Mm.
Now over here, what you will do, so this will give you your M1, is it?
Mm.
Here you will find.
Mm.
So for this one, you will consider this distance as
x1.
For this one, you will consider this distance as
x2.
Correct?
Correct.
You can also start from here, right?
No.
Mm.
But there will be a little bit change, right? Okay.
Mm.
Now, how this equation will be changed now? Delta V. So it has two parts now, right?
Mm.
One is with one value, other is with
two
value, okay? Yes.
The integration would be two.
Yes,
yeah.
Two part. So therefore, we can write it as
summation.
Delta V, yes, of two part, right? It is equal to, for this part, right, for one part, okay?
Yes.
M1, small m1, over
three.
EI, it is from 0 to
3.
Is it?
Yes.
So it is from 0 to 3, small m1, capital M1, over E I into
dx1.
Yes. Can you see? This is x1, right? Plus, for this one, what is the limit of x2? It will be from 0 to
3
again, right? It is again from 0 to 3.
Yes.
Not 0.
It is m2, capital M2 over
E
I into
dx2,
okay?
Yes.
Not from
3
to
6. No. Because we are, our what is the value of x2 over here? It is?
Zero.
How much maximum it can reach? It can reach up to?
Three,
right?
Yeah.
Okay. So now these are the values. So therefore, now we need to consider the small m1, small m2, capital M1,
capital
M2. Okay. So now, by using this one, first I am finding the M1 and M2, okay? So, sorry, I don't left space over here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I am going to erase it. I will draw this one over here again, right? Is it okay?
Yes.
This is our page 1. Okay. This is our page 2. This is page 3. Is it?
Yeah.
And this is our page 4, okay? Clear?
Okay.
So now I am going to move this one.
Clear? Yeah.
Basically, from here to. Now for M1, right?
Yes.
So for M1, so this load is 30 kilonewton. This UTL is 10 kilonewton per meter. Here is your M1. This distance is X1. So easy. So M1, capital M1, it will be equals to
30 into x1.
30x1 over 2 minus 10x1 square over 2. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes. 10x1 into x1 over 2, right?
Yes.
So it will be 10x1 square over 2.
So
it is equal to 30x1 minus 5x1 square. Okay, now for M2, right? This is for capital M. Okay. Now for M2, again the same thing is happening, right? This is 30 kilonewton, and this UDL is this one, and this is 10 kilonewton per meter. From here to here, this distance is how much? It is X2, right? This is your M2, right? What is this distance? This is?
Three.
Okay, what will be going on for M2 now?
M2
30. So m2 it will be equal to what? It is equal to
30 into 3 plus 16.
Okay. Oh, sorry. Yeah. m2 it is equal to 30 into
3 plus
6.
x2 plus 3.
Yeah. Minus 10. 10 into
10 into
x2
plus
3.
x2 plus 3 it's square of
2.
Is that?
Yes.
Okay, so this m2 it will be equal to 30x2 plus 90 minus
10x2.
No, it will be 5, right?
Yes.
5x2 square
plus 3
minus
6. 6x2.
45 and then minus
6x2.
Minus 30. So it is, what is x plus 3 square? It is x square plus 9,
yes,
plus 6x, right?
Yes.
So I am also multiplying it with 5, right?
Mm.
So it will be 5x square. So 9 will be 45 and 6 will be 6
right.
Multiplied by 5, 30, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And all are minus, right? Because of this minus, is it?
Yes.
Okay, so therefore this equation it will be third, and everywhere it is x2, right?
Yes.
Okay, so 30x2 and 30x2, is it finished, right?
So you multiply a 5 before square or after square?
Huh?
You multiply 5 with the bracket before square and after or after square?
Divide.
Okay.
So it is outside, right? 10
yeah.
over 5, is it? Yeah. The square is only of the distance, not of the load.
Yes.
No, this one is finished. So this is minus 5x square.
Plus 45.
Plus
45.
Okay. So now we have found the value of m1
m2.
And value of m2. These two values are with us, right? Now, for
smaller.
Here we consider the second segment. But in the second segment, we take it from the middle. So there would be no 30 kilonewton. Right?
Sorry?
Here. We take m2 from the middle. Of the
We will cut it over here. We are going to cut it over here, right?
No.
Either consider this side or this side. Your answer will be same.
So
right?
x2 is from C to
from B. X2 is from B to this point.
Yeah. So B is there is no 30 kilonewton at B.
Okay. I'm going to make it simple, right? Cut it over here. This is x2.
Yeah.
But use this side to write the equation. What will be this distance?
X2.
X2 minus 3.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
Okay, use this part, write the equation, you will get the same answer.
If I start from the beginning, the limit of x2 from the beginning,
mm-hmm.
what will be the change?
The change is, because x2 it is not coming from here, right?
It will come from 3 to the 6.
Yes. So it is from, then your limits will be changed. Okay? Right. Okay, so this one is more easy, right? For each segment, start your distance from that segment point. Okay, and same thing we will use in the frames also. Okay, now this one is finished. This is over, right? Now for m, right?
Small m.
For small m,
yeah.
What will be m1 and m2?
Yes.
Okay, this page 3 is finished. Now page 4. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Now for m1, can I write directly m1 value?
Yes.
It's easy, right? It is 0.5 x1, is it?
Yes.
Yes.
0.5 x1. What will be m2 value? It is
0.5
0.5 into
3 plus
6.
3 plus x2
minus 1
minus 1 into
x2.
So it will be equals to 1.5
plus
0.5 x minus
x2
and x2. Is it?
Yes.
So this will be equals to 1.5
minus
0.5
x2.
So we have m1 and m2. So let's put all these things in our this basic equation. Okay. So now putting in 1. Okay. Now from 1. So delta b, right? Okay. What about ei? It is constant, right?
Yes.
I can take it
outside.
Okay. It is 1 over ei. It is from 0 to L. What is m1? 0.5x1 into capital X one is 30 x one.
Minus five x square.
Minus five x square. Okay. Then.
Dx.
Into dx one. Okay. Plus 0 to 3. Okay. Now m two is 1.5 minus 0.5.
X two.
X two into.
Minus five.
Minus five.
X square plus 45.
X two square.
Plus 45.
Plus 45 into. Dx. Okay, now here let's go back to our school, right? So we need to multiply and take the integration, right? Okay. So over here it is equal to 1 over ei. Okay, what will be this integration? Can you help me? This will be first multiply it.
Yeah.
So it is 15x1.
2.5x3.
Do we make it integration also?
Yeah.
I think it should be easy, right? 15x1 square over.
No,
2.
It will be cube, sir. Yes, cube.
It
cube.
Will be 15x cube.
Over 3.
Over 3.
Minus
2.5
x 4.
X 1, 4 divided
over
4. By 4. Limit is from 0 to
0 3.
Easy, right? Okay, then what is this one plus? Now here, maybe we need to do a little bit more. But anyways, we can also integrate it. 1.5 into 5. This is minus. Be careful, right?
Mm.
So it is minus 7.5 into x 2. Cube over
yeah.
3, is it?
3, yes.
So this one will be 1.5 into 45, is it?
Yes.
This is plus, right? So 1.5 into 45, it will be 67.5, is it? So 67.5, and there is no x, right? So this is only x2, is it correct?
Yes.
Okay, this will be plus 0.5 into x, 2.5.
x4 over 4.
X4 over 4, and this will be minus 22.5 into x2 square over
2.
It is also from 0 to
3.
Okay. So it means now everywhere we need to put 3 and get the answer, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. So what will be your answer? Is equal to
168.75 over here.
168.75 over
here. Yeah.
Second integration,
which
will be 0 to
3.
Sorry? Second integration from 0 to
3, 1. Because our x2, it will be from this point to this one. When it is over here, x2 will be 0. When x2 reaches over here, it will be 3.
Okay, but the first one from 0 to L. So be all.
This is 0 to
3,
obviously. Okay. Okay, 168.75, it is positive, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what is meaning of positive?
Or
so our displacement, it is in the direction of unit load, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what is the direction of unit load? It is downward.
No.
And we are getting the same answer, right?
Oh.
And that is positive. Clear?
Yes.
Clear.
Right. So next one. For the rotation, what do we have to do now?
Same.
For
zero.
Rotation, right?
Zero.
So again, you will consider here, I am going to change it on this problem, right? Fine?
Fine.
Okay. Okay, now for theta b, right? So over here it will be theta b. So here it will be theta b and m theta, is it correct?
Yes.
So this equation, it will be same. So here m theta 1 and m theta 2. Same, right? This concept is same. So capital M1, capital M2, these are same.
Mm-hmm.
Only change will be in this part.
Yes.
Is it correct?
Yes.
Okay, so this part I am going to write it again. Clear?
Alright.
Okay, so for this one, I am going to apply a unit rotation, right? At point
B.
Now here, I am going to apply a unit rotation. Okay, in which direction I can apply?
Any
direction, right? So there will be no difference, you will see, right? So over here, let's consider rotation is in this direction, and this is unit, right? What will be this reaction and this reaction? I think it will be 1 over 6. This is in this one, therefore this will be 1 over 6, and this will be 1 over 6. Please correct me if there is some mistake, right? Is it correct? So I apply a unit rotation at point, unit movement, right? External
okay.
movement at point B, right?
Okay.
So what is movement? It is 1. So I need from the reaction 1, right?
1 over 6, yeah.
So it will be 1 divided by length, right?
Yes.
So length is 3 plus 3 is 6. So 1 over 6, I think it's correct.
Yes.
Okay. So now, where will be m1? So here at distance, x1, right? You will find small m theta 1. And at this distance, x2, you will find m theta 2, is it?
Yes.
Okay, what will be m theta 1?
1 over 6.
1 over 6. For small, for m theta, right?
Hmm.
So m theta 1, it will be equal to, that means over here, 1 over 6 m2, x1. So it means x1 over 6,
yes.
M positive, right?
Yes.
Okay, then, what about m theta 2?
1 over 6.
M theta 2, it will be equal to
1 over 6.
1 over 6 into
3 plus 6 2. X2.
3 plus x2
plus 1
plus 1
hmm.
minus 1 minus 1 okay
hmm.
So about this point,
yes.
This is in this direction, this is in this direction.
So it will be,
so over here it will be equals to 1 over 6 into 3,
yeah.
It will be equals to 1 over 2 plus x2 over 6
minus
1 minus 1, so it will be equals to x2 over 6
minus
0.5, is it?
Yes.
Okay, so now you have the value of x, m theta 1 and m theta 2. Let's put these values in our this equation. Okay?
Okay.
So, I think it is in sequence, right?
Yes.
You are following, is it?
Yes, sir.
I am not confusing you, is it? Theta b, this is theta b, right? So theta b, it will be equal to 0 to 3. Okay, what is capital M1? Okay, small m1, it is x1 over 6. This is how much capital M1, can you help me? It is 30x1 minus
5x squared.
Minus 5
x squared.
X1 square into
dx1
plus 0 to 3, small m2 is x2 over 6 minus half.
Minus half. Multiply by minus 4, minus 5,
minus
x squared.
X2 square.
Plus 45.
Plus 45 into
dx.
Dx2, right? Okay. So this one, let's multiply and integrate as well. So this will be x5,
x
right? 5x1 cube over 3 minus 5 over 6 x1 4 over 4, is it correct?
Yes.
Plus, and limit is from, excuse me, there is 1 over EI, okay?
Yeah.
Outside, okay? Plus 1 over EI. So it is equal to 1 over EI.
Okay.
And this limit is from 0 to 3, okay? What about this one? This will be minus 5 over 6, is it? Plus? Minus 5 over 6 into
over
x2
4 over 4.
4 over
4.
4. Then it will be plus 45 over 6 into x2 square over 2. Then minus, right? So it will be plus
2.5.
It will be 2.5
x cube
x2 cube over 3. And then minus
25
22.5 into
x2
and it is also from
0 to 3
to be 0,
yeah, it should be, but are you getting same?
Yes.
So this gives you the 0, right?
Yes.
Okay, so you can put but 3 over here, right? When you keep on solving, your answer is 0.
Yes.
It means rotation at point B is how much? It is
0.
0. Okay, clear. And displacement. So only you need to be a little bit careful, right? That in the calculation part, right? And also a little bit careful when you are selecting the
segment.
Okay. Time is over, right?
Yes.
1 minute over, is it?
Yes.
1 minute extra. If you don't mind, I can just show you one example from your book, okay? And then we can talk. I tell you that this beam, it is made up of steel, right? Okay. Now this beam is made up of
steel.
Beam is made up of
steel,
right? And its cross section is, it is 6 meters, right? So you can use a box section, and this box section, this width is, this you can consider as 700 millimeter, and this is 30 millimeter, and this thickness is 30. This is also 30. All these thicknesses are 30. Can you find the moment of inertia for this one?
Yes.
So what will be I value?
PH cube over 2.
So
over
I,
three.
It is equal to PH cube over 12. So
minus
outer minus inner, right?
Yes.
It is 300 into 700. It's cube over 12
minus
this one is 30 minus 60. It is
240.
240 into 640. It's cube over
12.
Is it?
Yes.
So this will give you the millimeter for, can you tell me? What is this answer of? Only? No, tell me in the 10 to the power 4 or 10 to the power 6. So what is your answer?
3.12
10 to the power 6?
Yes.
Okay, so I is known, right? Now what will be E for this case?
200,000
megapascal, is it?
Yes.
Okay, what will be value of EI? Mind it, usually in the exam, I give the section, right? So you need to calculate EI by yourself.
Okay.
Okay. So can you tell me what is value of EI over here now?
صح ميجا باسكال ومليمتر صح
but the important thing is you need to be careful about the unit. What is unit over here? It is millimeter. It is megapascal. In your question, what are units? It is kilonewton and meter. So it means over here you need to consider EI and it should be in unit of kilonewton and meter.
Okay.
Okay. So what will be this one in so this is 200,000. What is megapascal into 10 to the power 6? Is it?
Yes.
This newton per meter square, is it?
Yes.
So it will be equal to 200 into 10 to the power 6 kilonewton per meter square, is it?
Yes.
Okay, what will be EI? So it is in millimeter force. So 2.12 10 to the power 6 divided by 1000 raised to power 4, is it?
Yes.
Okay, so it will become 3332.12 10 raised to power minus 6. So what will be value of EI? So just put EI in the delta equation, right? And tell me what is this value, okay? Can you find? What is EI? Just multiply 200 with this one. So it will be 6664.12 into 10 to the power 2, right? 66412. And you multiply these two ones, you will get 66424.
Sorry. 24, yes.
So then just put that value over here and find the value of delta, right? So 168.75 divided by 66424, right?
Yes.
What is the answer? It will be very small.
24. Doctor, if I multiply millimeter by megapascal, will already give me a newton newton meter, right?
Millimeter.
Yeah, this is mega. Mega is 10 to the power 6. Pascal is newton per meter square.
Megapascal
is newton millimeter square, right?
Yeah.
right? Newton per millimeter. But I need in kilonewton and meter, right? Because here it is kilonewton and meter, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you can put it and find the final answer, right?
No. 0.0005.
0.30. Unit meter. Okay, what will be millimeter? It is 0.25 millimeter. This is correct. Okay, so now in your book, if you see. Okay, so this one is basically the first topic. It is about the displacement of trusses by using virtual work method, right?
Yes.
Can you see? This one, method of virtual work for the trusses, right? Method of virtual work for the trusses, is it? So when it finishes, so actually there is a problem in the sequence, right? Then the next one is the Kostek-Lennox theorem for the trusses, right? But I skipped it, right? So I directly jump to the next topic, that is about the method of virtual work for beam and frame, is it?
Yes.
And these are the two equations which we are using. So delta equation and theta equation, is it?
Yes.
And whatever are these variables, m, delta, we have discussed it, right?
Yes.
And then, in the next with this page, it is written a step-by-step procedure, right? What we applied over here, how to find the small m, how to find the capital M, and how to use your equation, right? And then this method, it is applied on this simply supported, this cantilever beam, right? To find the rotation at the free end, is it?
Yes.
Okay, and you are getting two values of M, small M and capital M, is it?
Mm-hmm.
So this is capital M, this is
small
M, right? And we are getting the value of displacement, okay? Then next problem is this one, okay? So determine the slope at point B, right? Further. Now beam is this one, it is a cantilever beam. You need to find slope at point B, right? So what you will do? You need two segments. One this one, other is this one. And over here you will apply a external moment, right?
Yes.
And this thing, it is shown here. Can you see? For the small m, what is happening? We are applying a movement in this direction.
Yes.
Okay? And we are cutting one section over here, other over here. Can you see? We are making x2 distance from this point, x1 distance from this point, okay?
Yes.
Then, now we are considering movement in this direction, right? So what will happen at the end? Can you guess?
We
will get the negative answer, right?
Yes.
So, over here.
Which is a negative.
Yes.
So, and then, for the capital M, right?
Yes.
So this is for the, portion is for capital M, right? So exactly, kilonewton load is applied. Now you will put in original equation. You have the two parts, is it?
Yes.
So when you will solve it, your final answer is negative, right? And this is in radian, is it? This is negative. What it means?
Assumption.
So our assumption was, what was our assumption? Over here, that it is going to be displaced like this way, right? Rotation is in this direction, but actually load is applied in downward direction, right? Rotation is in this direction, is it?
Yes.
So obviously we will get the negative one. Clear? Okay, with this one, this topic is over. And, excuse me, same, you can apply for this person and this frame, right? Okay, okay, no problem. Next time, inshallah, I will show you how to apply this method for the frame, right? Okay, but exactly the same procedure, okay? Okay, so that's all.